this is sort of the culminating event of our semester, where students are investigating a mock crime that I set up.
Okay, you guys, this all is evidence.
Obviously, we have multiple agencies here to coordinate, and they are in teams of four, and they're playing a lead detective, a homicide detective, and two forensic scientists per group. So today, a car exploded on campus. A fake meat student was inside, and we had another victim near the car as well, and they're being backboarded by the paramedics right here.
We're trying to comfort him now. He's pretty upset.
His girlfriend Jessica was in the car, and he was dropping her off after we all went on a double date, and then the car blew up as he was walking away.
He's gone.
So we have six classes of forensics going right now, and numerous teams trying to solve this. So this is sort of the kickoff of the scenario that they're trying to figure out. From here till the end of school, they will interview people around campus. It could be students, administrators, counselors, people like that. They need to find evidence around campus beyond what they find at the scene. They might need search warrants. I have a judge set up to go in front of the judge and get the search warrant granted for things like lockers and backpacks and cars. Hopefully some teams will solve it. Not everybody will. It's a pretty intricate crime, and it's due at the beginning of May, so they have a month. You know, it's amazing for me to see students, you know, putting the pieces of the puzzle together. It's really an amazing experience for me when I see their faces and they know they've solved it. I haven't helped them. This is probably the first time in high school where they haven't been spoon-fed the answer the next day or the next week or the next month. It's like they have to go for 5 weeks without knowing the answer, and I don't tell them the answer, you know. But the ones that solve it, they know deep down inside that they have, and that's, you know, why I wake up in the morning. So.